We continue with the participation of Dr. David Celdran, who has a PhD in marine ecology, master in aquaculture, and bachelor in environmental science by the University of Murcia. Active collaborator of the SNI in Mexico, and several laboratories in France, South Korea, Australia, and Mexico. Consulting of the International Foundation of Conservation in Costa Rica, an international advisor for different technologies and companies. Editor of Ingeniente Seed and academic tutor of PhD on Symbiotics Technology. Founder of the Symbiotic Web Aquaculture, bioflog.com. Hello, how are you? I am Dr. David Celdran, doctor in marine ecology and international consultants, and I want to take this opportunity to thank the organizers of CONAQUA for the invitation into this congress, to this presentation that I have to be of use and with you here. Well, I've been working on symbiotic aquaculture for the last 11 years, more into point the last 6. We've been working with ferments, predigested food, bioflocks, and our line of research. We are working with several aquaculture species, especially with tilapia, some amazonicas, and cachava, and moreover with shrimp of the Lithopeneus benamei, peneus, even macrobrachium. Once that being said, I go to talk about this that presentation that is called Microorganisms and Ferments Predigested as Symbiotic Foods. And that's the title, and that's what we are going to be talking about now. We always begin our presentation speaking or talking about that in the world of the aquaculture, we focus to the marine organisms, to the feeding, but it's always important to know to whom is directed all that effort. And that effort is directed to people. So we are here using the nutrition and the aquaculture to feed aquatic organisms that feed people. So it's very important to know how are these people. And those people are going to be a lot. In the year 2050, the FAO calculates that we are going to be almost 10 billion people. But not just that, of those 10 billion people, 70% is going to be urban population, on regard that now that we are not even in 50% of urban population. That's going to bring some lifestyles and a differentiation on the diets of the people, that usually the people that live in city have diets more with more protein and more foods, which also push us to a demand of food that is current in existence and is being reflected on the consumption of the in excess of certain products, the fisheries. That's why now we are in a situation of overfishing, with more than 60% of the wild populations overexploited at the commercial level of those commercial species. In that base, with that increase on demand of food, the aquaculture seemed like a solution to this problem. And well, we were very good. As a matter of fact, in 2018, we were able to produce 80 million tons, which was almost 45% of everything that is being eaten in fish and different fishes in that year. And now the FAO let us know that the aquaculture and fishing nowadays is bringing that we are around 50%, 52% of all the fishes and seafood that come from the aquaculture at world level. Very important. Moreover, the demand increases. The annual production of meat, it should be around 470 million tons to feed all that population.
que la acuicultura supusiera una solución
That the
para la sobrepesca en
aquaculture
estos
was a
últimos años,
solution
aunque
for
saben
the
desde los años
overfishing
70
in the
que
last
hemos
year. As you know, since the
pescado de manera
70s,
intensiva
we
y
are
eso nos ha
in
llevado a
fishing
nuestro momento
intensively, and
actual
that
de
brought
mucha
us
sobrepoblación
to
pesquera.
where we are
Seguimos
now
teniendo
of
el problema de
overfishing.
sobrepoblación humana,
We
así que
still
ahora
haven't
tenemos
the
dos problemas, ¿no?
overpopulation
Sobrepoblación y
problem, so now we
sobrepesca.
have two
La
problems,
acuicultura de repente
overpopulation
se
and
configura
overfishing.
como
The
una solución
aquaculture,
y le da
so then it
futuro
looks like a
hasta el punto de
solution, and
consumir
we hit
más de
it
la
hard
mitad
until
de
the point
los
that
pescados
we
que consumimos
more than
son
half
de
the post-consumption
acuicultura
that
mediada por nosotros. Sin
we eat
embargo, hay un pequeño
seafood and the
detalle muy
fishes are
importante
from
en esta
aquaculture, but
cadena,
there's a little
¿verdad?
thing
Y
here
es que
on this
hasta
chain,
ahora
and is that
necesitamos
until
que
now,
todos los
we
animales,
need
pero
that
también
all
los
the
acuáticos que
animals,
cultivamos,
aquatic
todos
organisms that we have in a
necesitan
culture,
ácido graso esencial que
all
se llama
of them
DHA, que
need
lamentablemente tiene su
DHA,
origen solo y exclusivamente marino.
basic
De
fat, that
manera
it
que
comes
la
only from
fuente
the
de
sea.
DHA más
So
barata,
the
siempre a nuestro
source
alcance,
of
es la harina de
DHA,
pescado y el
the
aceite de
cheapest
pescado,
one,
es
the
decir,
one that we
el
find at
pescado,
the
¿no?
fish meal, and
Capturamos en
it,
el mar.
so to speak, the
Entonces,
fish
todos
that
los
we captured at the
alimentos
sea.
balanceados
So
tienen que tener
all the
un
foods,
porcentaje
all the balanced
de
food must have a
aceite de
percentage
pescado o harina de pescado
of
para que
fish
pueda
oil o
nutrir
fish meal,
a nuestros organismos
so
acuáticos.
they
Sin
are able
este
to
DHA,
nutri
no
have
pueden
be
crecer.
proper nutrition
Esto ha
for of
supuesto
aquaculture
una
of farm
esclavitud
animals,
del mundo
or they
acuícola
can grow.
con
That
respecto a la
make a
pesca.
slavery into the
Entonces,
aquaculture
como pueden
towards the
entender, no ha
fishing.
sido una
As
solución
you may
el tener
understand,
que
it's not
pescar,
been a
¿verdad?
solution to having
Animales
to
salvajes
fish
para hacer harina y aceites de
while
pescado y elaborar
animals to
alimento
make
balanceado para nuestros animales de
fish
acuicultura.
meal or
Eso
different
sigue siendo
oils for
insostenible.
our animals in aquaculture.
Hay algunas
That's not
fuentes
sustainable.
actualmente de
There are
DHA
certain
como
sources
microalgas
now of
y
DHA
hay
like
empresas que están
microalgae,
dirigiendo su
and
esfuerzo
there are
a hacer
companies and they
industria
are directing
eventual,
their
¿no? Lo
effort
cual
to
es
the
muy
production
interesante,
of
pero todavía a nivel
microalgae oil.
tecnológico no
That's
ha
very
superado la
interesting, but in
barrera
the technological level, they have not been able to
del
overcome the
costo de
barrier
producción. Entonces, ahora
of the
mismo son
price
muy
production
interesantes a
price. So
nivel
now it's very
científico,
interesting
cultural, pero
at
no son
a
interesantes a
scientific
nivel
level and
económico
productive, but
todavía,
they are not
todavía.
interested in at
En este
economical level
punto
so
es
far.
cuando entra en
At this
acción,
point is
digamos,
where it
la
comes
tecnología
into action,
simbiótica
so to speak,
o
the
lo que llamamos
symbiotic
la alimentación
technology, or what
simbiótica,
we
¿verdad?
call
No es lo
the
mismo. La tecnología simbiótica
symbiotic
es una
feeding. It's not the
tecnología
same that the
biotox, una
symbiotic
tecnología
technology is a
simbiótica.
technology
Aquamimesis
like
una
bioflux,
tecnología
is a
simbiótica.
technology,
La
Aquamimic is
aplicación de
another
fermentos, de digeridos,
symbiotic technology. The
etcétera,
application
que
of
algunos de ellos son
predigested
alimentación
ferments,
simbiótica,
that
son
some of them
técnicas.
are symbiotic
Pero
foods
aquí,
are technical.
en esta
But
exposición,
here
no vamos a centrar tanto en las
on
tecnologías,
this
¿verdad?
conference we're
Como la
gonna
que
talk
desarrollamos
so
nosotros,
much on
híbridos de
technologies, but the
bioflux
one
y
that we
aquamimesis, sino en la
produce
alimentación
one
simbiótica.
between hybrid, but
Y
mainly in
pues
the
deben de
symbiotic
saber que el
feeding.
alma de
And
estas
well,
tecnologías, de estas
as you may
innovaciones,
know,
es que
that the
en el
soul of
agua,
these
¿verdad?,
technologies
tenemos
is that in the
zooplancton
water
y
we
bioflujos
have
que
zooplancton and
precisamente
bioflocks,
son muy ricos
which
en
precisely
DHA,
are very
en
rich
ácidos
on
lipoproteicos
DHA
omega. Entonces, si
and
tenemos unos
acid,
organismos que
the
tienen,
zooxanthellaicos. So we
viven
have
en un
organisms
ambiente
that they
con un
have,
aporte
they live in an environment
muy importante de DHA,
with a
eso nos lleva a
very
pensar que a lo
source of
mejor
DHA that bring us
podríamos
that
evitar las
perhaps
harinas de
we
pescado, los aceites
may
de pescado y la
avoid
harina de
the fish
pescado.
meal and the
Y
fish
te
oils on the
preguntas como
balanced foods.
estadístico,
That question
somos
was
investigadores, aquí
made by
ponemos
several
dos ejemplos,
researchers.
hay muchos
Here
artículos
we have two
científicos al
examples.
respecto.
There are
Por
several
ejemplo,
scientific articles
Bauer y
on regards
colaboradores en
that.
2012
Bauer and
hicieron una
collaborator in
prueba en la que
2012
sustituyeron
made a
cuatro
test
dietas de
where they
alimento balanceado,
substituted four diets
sustituyeron en
of
la
balanced
primera 25% de
food. They
alimento balanceado por
substitute
flocus,
25% balanced food
flocus
by
que
flocus.
principalmente son
Flocus
bacterias,
that
bacterianas del
mainly
plancton.
are
Entonces
from
sustituyeron el
bacteria and
25% por
zooplancton.
flocus,
So
un
they
poquito de soja,
substituted
¿verdad?, para
25% by
aumentar la
flocus
proteína.
and a little bit of soja
Otros en
to
otra dieta
increase the
sustituyeron el
protein.
50%,
Another
¿verdad?
one
50% era alimento balanceado,
percent
50% flocus y soja.
50% balanced
En
food,
otra
50%
dieta
flocus and
sustituyeron el
soya.
75% y
And
otra
another
dieta
diet,
sustituyeron todo alimento
75%,
balanceado,
and
solo
another one
sustituyeron
they substituted all the
flocus y
balanced
soja.
food, 100%, and only bioflocus and soya.
Lo interesante del experimento es que
The interesting of the
respecto al
experiment is
crecimiento, los
that
factores de
on
conversión del
regards the
alimento, la
growth on the
supervivencia,
conversion
los
factors and
animalitos en
survival,
todas las dietas
the
crecieron
animals in all
exactamente
the
igual.
diets
Es
growth
decir,
the same.
sustituir el 100% del
That
alimento
is to say, so
no
substituting
produjo un efecto
100% of the
negativo en
food
el
did not produce a
crecimiento de
negative
este animal que
effect
fue
on the
nuestro
growth
problema
of this animal, which was
actualmente de camarón,
concretely shrimp,
Esto fue y
Phytopneus
es un
baname.
hito en la acuicultura, el
And
hito
this
de
is a
alimentar
point of
nuestros
breaking point
organismos
on
con una
the
fuente
aquaculture, being able
diferente
to feed
de
our
harina y el
organisms
aceite
with
de
a different
pescado
source
y
from fish
que
meal and fish oil,
crezcan
and
igual
that they grow the same or even better. And I say this because Sukunin collaborators found some growth that they are above of the usage of fish meal and fish oil. And more precisely, in 5 weeks, they were able from half a gram to 8 grams, which is a spectacular growth, just substituting some diets, experimental diets, with a little bit of soy and flocculus, bacterial flocculus. This, yes, it is a breaking point on the modern aquaculture, being able to feed our organisms with bioflocculus and that they grow equally or better than the fish meal or fish oils. So, we talk about the symbiotic aquaculture as a new paradigm that basically is focused or is sustained by flocculus and ferments, a minor or relationship of water and a bigger production with a less impact. Flocculus and ferments is basically the soul of those technology and is the food, the symbiotic food that we are talking about. Not just means food, but also produces different substances that protect for diseases. We might be spend a whole afternoon about the positive effects of those substances, but the organic acids of short chain, the PHA, polyvalent, and other substances are the effects that generate those bioflocculus and substances that they are produced on the ferments and that they are beneficial for organisms, on the health of such organisms. As we say, and one of the main parts of them are a direct food, the microorganisms associated with the flocculus, as well as the flocculus itself as a ferment, or one class of ferment in particular that is the predigestic. And well, this symbiotic aquaculture is based in a less interchange of water that produces at the same time less diseases, because most of the pathogen agents comes through the water exchange. And on the other, since we don't do so much water exchange, we are doing that the nitrogen that is in our tank, they are not wasted into the environment and produce contamination. Those nitrogen substance is money, since it's that make grow the organism, they make the muscle grow, but they are in a way, they are not possible to be used. They are on heifers, ammonia, nitrito. Those substances are toxic, as a matter of fact. So the symbiotic aquaculture, the technology symbiotic, since they are not so much exchange of water and applying certain substances as ferments and a certain protocol of care and taking care of the physicochemical parameters, we achieve that the substances, toxic substances, are included once again in the cycles, are absorbed by the microorganisms, they grow, and they are able to clean the water and feed our organisms. So we use about 80% of the nitrogen that was wasted, that was used again, and it comes into microorganisms and in the meat of our animal in the culture, which is very interesting. But of course, it's a technology that produces super intensive productions in small spaces, right? Talking about the super intensive production, we say that is plus more for less, because we make an use of less soil, less land. We don't use as much water and much food. We don't use basically supplements or antibiotics, and all that is translated in a less impact. So it's more benefits for less impacts. In all the conferences, always are asked that, we say, and how much it costs that? Always, what is the price? Okay, it's great, but how much it is? Here we have a real table here. We also use it in Central America, the aquaculture over there. We do collaboration with academies, institutes, research institutes as well, with particular partners. So we do experiments in research centers, universities like the one that we have here in the UTN and Costa Rica, but also we farm ourselves and we give advice to other producers. So The real data might be on an hectare. Let's say that on a cycle of 4 months, we may have a cost of larvae, food, the rent, different wages to $75,000 per hectare per year, but we have a benefit of $220,000, which comes to $144,000 per year. And with symbiotic technology, we assist our different tanks with the aerators that we have with 78 horsepower on our tanks of 1 hectare. So as a base, as a soul of those technologies, and this feeding, symbiotic feeding, is the generation of bioflocks and supplant. The theory of generation of bioflocks and supplanton is very interesting, and it comes that we come from a nucleotide agent that we promoted in our protocols. In our experiments, we add a different semolin dose that grow before we fermented. And this is a nucleant agent that a bacteria attaches itself that we add to the water. We use a variety of bacteria and also different yeast. The bacteria are probioticals, Bacillus subtilis and Lactobacillus. And this bacteria comes to the nucleotic agent, maybe a particle of dust or a little piece of epithelium or anything that it may attach to it, and generate a protein, a glued protein called exopolysaccharidos that adheres to the bacteria, to the nucleant agent. Another bacteria that they make more glue, more bacteria attached to it, they produce much more exopolysaccharidos, and this is a protoflocul that not just make the organic matter dissolve on the tank into it, so it starts to be flocular and the water starts to look transparent with little spheres that look flocculous, and is colonized by zooplankton that represents rotifers, Rotifers, sessiles, microalgae, nematodes, and at the end we find with a mature flocule with associated zooplankton inside and outside that represent a feeding and a symbiotic feeding, truly interesting and very, 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 very important for our organism, aquatic organisms, for everything that they provide, and that we will see in the following slides. So, which is the paper of the bioflocus on the feeding? Well, the including of those bioflocus on the diet is a positive effect. That has been widely described. CIPAN proved that, and that they also increased the activity, enzymatic activity on the shrimp. Also bring a better yield on the growth, on the enzymatic activity of the carp, and some fishes, and in shrimp, of course, and in experiments in Hanals in 2004, that with increases of 4% in Puna monodem and a tiger shrimp, it generates a very interesting growth. The bioflocus, we may say that they are composed of a bacterial matrix associated and composed also by plankton, among them microcrustaceans and algae, that they have DHA. It's an element highly proteic, the flocus. It's a sort not of DHA, but of the succinoicos, but exopentenoicos, the EPA, alinoleico, arachidonico, and a bunch more of fatty grass, fatty acids, essential fatty acids. This characterizes the flocculum. It can be produced all year. We, up to now, in the symbiotic world, in the aquaculture, in symbiotic aquaculture is being generated in the same tanks by the same aquaculture, or in research, by researchers, as we are doing in several universities. However, this is something that has a great projection in the future, because those bioflux can be generated and from bioreactors all year long, without interference of diseases by animals, using sources of nitrogen, of wasted nitrogen, and without having an impact on the environment. Also, it will be a food, a free fish meal, which is free of fish meal. This potential or this potential intake that has not to do with the different floors of poultry or pork is an option that now is still to be evaluated seriously. So from here, always, we call into the different feeding houses to let them know that it's a great opportunity in the business. There's still a lot of room to be exploited. The inclusion of bioflocks on the balanced food and zooplanktoc may bring great yields with low production cost, and keeping the nutrition standard of nutrition necessary with the fatty acids and everything for the growth. In quality, there's several research being carried out, and England collaborators did 38% of protein among other nutrients, but many and little. In 2008, they saw another ones even to a 50% of raw protein. The bioflocal by itself, half of the bioflock can be raw bioprotein and of high digestibility, which is very interesting for the aquacultural organisms. So up to now, the aquaculture, the symbiotic aquaculture, has been coming from laboratories and jumped into the different farms, but nowadays is a little bit still without being properly exploited. It's necessary the exploitation, especially by the industry of the balanced food. So up to now, in a far, far away galaxy, we always do the comparison, the funny comparison. They are two strange different races, that is the research and the aquaculture, the two different species that they interlace, that they come together. It's been a necessary symbiosis that is bringing fruits, and it is generated this technology that they come from the 70s with the bioflock technology, and then in Thailand in 2013 as BioMimicklin was born, what after translated into aquamimicry with using of ferments, and now they're terrible without mentioning the technicals with the ferments of different fruits or different vegetables. The inclusion of this technology brings us to a lot of research, investigation, universities apply experiments, different papers, and new advancements, and field tests all over the world. Nowadays, they are just one article that names the word symbiotic aquaculture. One, there's several of aquamimicic and several of bioflux, some of them Casi, but it's just some technology they are just beginning new, but with a lot of push, and they are driving hard because they are based on the use of microorganisms to generate services to aquaculture that up to now has been only being with different machines, with heavy machine or expensive machines, or with foods rich on fish meal, fish oil. So now the microorganisms that are being generated on those technologies, they are changing that high technification and those demands, over demands of different fish products. Now let's talk a little bit about the benefits quickly on the ferments, because it's one of the points that within the symbiotic aquaculture is getting more attention nowadays. In some countries, yes, we talk about symbiotic as predigestic foods, just only in that, but it's not that. We need to break and talk about the holistic point of view, holistic technology. They take the quality of the water, the handling of the organisms, the density, aeration, the usage of certain different things in the ferment. It's not just to create a predigested food. It's a way lot than, more than that. But here we're going to talk about the ferments. The ingredients are pretty simple. Water, salvados, semolina, depending where you are. Rice, depending on where you are, to talk about that flour that comes from the peel of the cereal. It's like a subproduct, but we are doing some ferments from several years that they are having right now. That they are having very good result. The probiotics is the one they use for the fermentation, basically from the generous bacillus. There we have Salvo lactobacillus, Acylaticidae, Pedococcus, Bacillus subtilis, etc. The products that they are generated on the ferment, once that we put the ingredients, we chlorinate the water and the bran. Once that we include the probiotics and we ferment for 24 hours, we generate enzymes. And once that we digested, and the macronutrients, they create amylases, proteases, lipases that accumulate on the ferment, and they are very interesting on our culture. Once they broken the yield, they produce free sugars, to aminopeptides, peptides, to amino acids, divided up to fatty acids. And we have two products of a semi-digestic food that we call probiotic. And when they assimilate the probiotics, the nutrients, it starts to generate. They use, since we do not use aeration, we use a fermentative at the end of the electron transportation. There's another protein, other molecule that is not oxygen, and it's fermentative and produces an organic molecules, usually acids. It might be acido propionic, valeric, acetic, formic, etc. A very short chain on those fatty acids. And the probiotic not only produces those acids, but it reproduces. We can see growths of 10 to the 10 to, from 10 to the 9 to 10 to the 14 per milliliters on the bacterial colonies, which is explosion that we have in our probiotics. A kilogram of probiotic can cost from $2,220, depending on the country and the kind of probiotic. Here we use few grams on each ferment, and we generate a lot of probiotic bacteria that we put into the water, and it's a source of carbon. Yes. So all the products that they are generated, enzymes among them, the cellulase, create a control of the microalgae and a bigger concentration on the early morning hours, because they are very prejudicial because they consume a lot of oxygen and our animals may die. So the cellulase that is produced by those elements, they break do not eliminate the cellulose, but it controls the population. But the prejudiced food are sustained for the bioflux that eat those ferments. The organic acids of short chain are very, very studied as antagonic agent, pathogen agents. They fight the diseases, and those acids decrease the pH and diminish the toxicity of the ammonia. And it's more into the useful ammonia for them. And it's increased on the survival and general health. That is done by the probiotics on the intestine, increasing the mucus of the intestine, making more acidic the medium, producing vitamins, a lot of benefits, and a balance of the carbon and nitrogen on the tank, because the ferment is still being a source of heat. Basically, we do three ferments. One of them is special, the soy one. We do a predigested. So the objective of the ferment and the brand of rice, we mentioned it very fast, generation of organic organic fatty acid change or change small change. In this ferment, we use Bacillus subtilis, which has been proved that is antagonic. That means that fights and displays a lot of pathogen agents, Vibrios, Bulificus, Paramoleticus, Alginolyticus, and increases the survival of the larvae. We have also seen that the predator nitrogen substances, the nitrate ammonia, and it also has an antifungal product and degrades the different skeletal, the exoskeleton of the swim because have an action of degrading the acetylcysteine glucosamine, which is part of the exoskeleton of the shrimp. So we do another special ferment. This is ours of different kind of different kind of honeys and yeast, and we create a grand amount of carbonic acid and control the pH and the yeast itself. We use the usual yeast that you can find in the supermarket. The same one that is used for the beer, for example, is better, have a better, generates a better growth ratio and the growth itself of the animals, and also we have seen that it has an influence on the osthermics and ambientalis, protect the animals of extreme variations of temperature, salinity, pH, etc. But the main one, the main benefit is that the immunostimulation, the beta-glucanos, that they are part of the wall of those yeast, activate the immunological system, but those substances are the ones that are recognized as dangerous, even if they are good, because they are just beneficial yeast, but they turn on the immune system when it comes a real pathogen, and the immune system is ready to attack the pathogen. And we have the ferment of soy from different vegetables and, well, and leguminous like beans, for example, a great amount of free amino acids, a source of carbon. In that we use Lactobacillus cantaro, and it can be used Lactobacillus subtilis, but those bacteria are in charge of generating certain enzymes that terminate those polymers, non-aminos, non-yeastical, that they are super judicial. The soya is a super food, but this has several factors against the nutrition, especially the inhibitors of trypsin. But in the fermentation, we end up with those ferments of the serina, trypsina. Those are the ferment allowed to finish those agents against nutrition, and we kept the best of the soya, but improved. Now we are going to see with the pre-yeasted food, because we were able to have more protein than even the same soya. And the same Lactobacillus plantaris generates also some effects against the stress and bigger growth on the organisms and an attack to the pathogen agents. So we don't only have those benefits that are bring by the own ferment, the juice of the ferment, but the bacteria that are within, they generate another beneficial effects. And well, to finish the predestined food that we have proved that has a higher percentage of protein than the soy. The soy, we can talk of percentage of 30-47% of protein. Well, however, on the fermentation, the bacteria fermentative increase the sugar, and it just by increasing the protein while decreasing the sugar and the bacteria the bacteria population and the bacteria bring a lot of protein, bacterial protein. So the pre-digested food are higher of 50% of protein, which they do not exist basically. So in the balanced food, because it will be too expensive, and pre-digested food is pretty easy to do, and those have those amounts of protein generated with proportion of water, so 2 to 1, depending the days of fermentation. They come to 2 to 50, depending if the soya is being preheated before, because if it's preheated, as they call it, a tort, they almost do not have anti-nutritional factors, and the fermentation may last only for 48 hours, and that's enough. Also, it may apply 1 or 2 times a week instead of food, but we have to say, and this has been proven, it's been published, that when it's used, the symbiotic technologies and the SBL flux, the substitution may be even 100%. But we have to be very careful when we say this, because the predigested food do not have DHA. Has to be very careful and make sure that we have enough bioflux and phytoplankton to pretend to change all the balanced food. On the an aquaculture and traditional aquaculture, it can be substituted 1 or 2 times a week, and they represent a good save in cost. The elaboration may come from 0.4 per kilogram when the balanced food are from 0.9, $1.2 per kilo. So it does represent between a 60% to 80% of benefit on saving and the cost. And well, as we say, the use of ferments is not new. Davut and Cosio this year, they did a review of 36 experiments with different aquaculture species fed with ferments and iconic species like Lithopenus banamei. Here, I'm going to do it very quickly, not too long. The presentation, we are almost finished. And here we can see a percentage of substitution of ferment of soya for balanced food that give a proper growth. Here they talk about 70%, 37 to 61, depending is fermenting soy. Experiments have been carried, not just Lithopenus banamei. Several more, as you can see, with tilapia too, also with soy meal, with canola. We have substitution up to 37%. With a great success on the growth and using different microorganisms, not just bacteria, but here we use different kind of yeast, and it was with Macrobrachium, also with soy flour, and doing a mixture of probiotics also in trout and salmon. They did research that the lactic acid produces very good benefit on nutrition, and the fermented soya flour also have an improvement on the growth of those fishes. And they mention it as a promising ingredient, a source of protein for the diet of trout and shrimp. There it is, the interest and the key of using those products, the ferments of different vegetables and cereals, as well as the production of bioflux production and bioreactors that can be used in new and formulas without depending some animal diseases of the market. But well, the soy and the cereals, they are within the markets. They are exposed to speculation a lot of time, but the production of bioflux and the zooplankton, well, is that still free of that and can be used to produce those foods. So to summarize, symbiotic foods, predigested food, ferments, plankton, flocals, mentioned briefly the biocoflock has the We are proud to and a pleasure to give different courses. We have those three protocols and several more and different topics. And any person that might be interested in those technology and those symbiotic foods can follow us in BioAcoFlock, where we put over that, and also on the webpage, bioaflock.com, and on the different courses. Just write to this email, and we send you all the information. Well, thank you. After this, thank you all, and be ready to the questions.